Well, a happy 3rd of July and a happy 20th birthday to Lane United goal scorer Timothy Mueller. We are set for this I-5 derby matchup, the Portland Timbers U-23s in town, and Lane United looking to get back on the right track after a rough game against the Kitsap Pumas, also looking to avenge a 2-0 loss in Portland earlier this season. And what do they have to do to make that happen?
Well, I think they need to realize their situation and realize that the season's not over yet, and they have plenty of capable players to turn this thing around. And today, in specific, they have a new lineup, a little bit more support going forward to Mueller with the addition of a second forward. And so we should see if that produces a little bit more opportunities going to goal.
Well, and right away we see a touch for the birthday boy, Timothy Mueller, and we see that physicality that he brings to the game. Nothing comes of it though. It's going to be a throw-in for the visiting Timbers. Headed away there. The starters for Lane United today: Brandon Anderson, Christian DeLuis, Jonathan Stadler, Amir Sasevarovic, Dirk Vanderveld, Alex Pantoa, Joseph Baldovi, Daly Stevens, and then Jordan Jones and Timothy Mueller up front, that prolific Oregon State Beaver combination. And Jones, we've been told, loves him some bicycle kicks. We'll see if we get a chance to see that today or if it's more of the Timothy Mueller show. Mueller has done not all of the scoring for Lane United this year, but he's done most of it. 7 goals in 9 league games, which is good enough to have him among the league leaders, not just in the Northwest Division, but in the PDL as a whole, as we see some attacking play here from Portland, and they'll get to the wing, get the cross in. There's a loud start, but DeLuis with the header knocked out of the box, and Portland have to sort of set up once again here. So they will go again for that same wing play, and it's towed out of play there by DeLuis. Another throw in Portland,
which is a different look by Portland Timbers. The first time around, Portland went out with the attack, well, being very attack minded on the middle of the field, and today they've switched that. Already have established the width and have had some services from the outside backs, so we'll see how if they stay consistent with that or if they go back to their previous attacking scheme, which was going down the middle of the field with multiple players.
And the ball has been stuck mostly in the Timbers attacking half of the field so far. Offside there against Portland, and a chance for Lane United to start over.
Timbers looking really aggressive in the attack, leaving 3 back and then pushing a back into that and pushing a holding mid even higher up to just really congest the space and really reduce it and not allow much of an outlet for Lane United.
This is a Timbers team, 6-1-3 in PDL play on the season. That's good enough for 2nd place in the Northwest Division with 21 points. However, their previous game on Sunday, they drew 1-1 against the Puget Sound Gunners, and that is not one of the leaders in this division.
No, we've...
It's a very top-heavy division with the Kitsap Pumas and then the Sounders and the Timbers U-23s all within kind of shouting distance of each other, and then about 10 points back is the 4th place team from there. So very very skilled division at the top, and I think Lane United's numbers would look a lot different in a lot of other leagues.
Yeah, after watching those teams, you saw some good discipline with spacing, you saw some good discipline with playing through the lines, playing through the midfield, getting it to the higher players. So it doesn't surprise me that they're sitting atop the league right now. And they managed to stay consistent, obviously, with their attacks. And defensively, very smart, very compact, and pretty consistent, keeping a block, which were those teams. And so that's sort of what Lane United have showed in previous matches with their defensive block, where they've been effective. It's just the offensive sort of the opportunities have kind of come and gone over the game. So we'll see if today they put a full game together.
And Lane United did a good job there of finding their maestro in the middle, Joseph Baldovi, but his pass was behind Timmy Mueller, out of play, and the throw-in was to the Portland Timbers. Isaac Rosenthal alongside Gabriel Hernandez. You are watching the Lane United Football Club on YouTube. We've been bringing you all the home broadcasts this year, and we got one more left after this one, coming to the end of a long road. It'll be Thursday the 9th against Washington Crossfire. Two more, excuse me.
So for viewers, keep an eye on number 23, Dirk Vanderveld. He has been asked to fill the role of Will Seymour, Hurtado that played in previous matches. He will play as a holding mid, mainly to probably clog up the middle and clean up anything in front of the center backs. But his challenge today will be getting the ball forward and not establishing the just going wide and establishing the wings, but to actually play penetrating balls forward through the seams. And that way you'll see more of a consistent attack from the guys you want to be in possession of the ball, which is, you know, Pantoja, Daly Stevens, and obviously Baldo. And we've seen what he can do when he gets the ball at his feet. So something to focus on if you're viewing. Number 23, Dirk Vanderveld.
And Vanderveld's kind of one of those players, as he goes in some ways, so goes the team. When he can turn it on and have a really good game, that's when Lane United can be at their best. And when they're not able to get him the ball, the 90 minutes can sometimes feel a lot longer than that. Ball of V runs onto it here. Tries to shield it away and will bring it back deeper into the midfield and now all the way back in defense.
Careful there.
Giving away. But no harm, no foul in the long run for Lane United. They get the ball back. Anderson touched it to Dirk Vanderveld, back to DeLuis, and now back to Bersano. Building from the back.
So Mueller already running away up top. Not much space there if the ball, like that ball, ended up over the top of the back line. Mueller needs to come to the ball in that case. He needs to realize where his line is, and in that case it was a line that was not very high. They were already reading the long ball, so got to be unpredictable and go to the ball, and then move the ball a little higher up the field and keep and stay in possession rather than playing over the top and running out of space. So let's see if the players will make that adjustment and recognize what Portland presents them. High line or a deep line like they just did.
And back to Baldo V now. He'll slide it all the way to the wing for Brendan Anderson. Anderson right back to Baldo and back again to the defense. Sasavarovic with it. He plays the long ball forward, but Mueller wasn't looking for it. So taken away by the Timbers. And Timbers trying to move out here. They're pressured early by Lane United, and Vanderveld takes the ball away. Tap by Baldovi for Daly Stevens. Stevens in some space. He will put his leg through that one, and it's wide.
More impressive, though, the pressure by Lane United here on this side of the field. You know, getting five or six bodies to win the ball back, and then countering with good numbers. So that was promising start defensively.
It's a great turnout today, this July 3rd matchup. It's a warm one, mid-90s at kickoff, and it's lucky we have that extra hour. Normally 7 o'clock starts. We began at 8 o'clock tonight. Should help cool a little bit down, and no foul in any of that sequence, would you believe it? Good passing there from Lane United. Good back heel from Mueller, and Baldo keeps it. Now eventually lost, and then a foul.
Great work by Baldo. Just all-around effort was phenomenal there.
No time to think or complain about the foul, though. The free kick taken quickly by the Timbers. And they'll start to push up the pitch. Jones and Mueller, the pair up top for Lane United, giving a little pressure on the back line, just making life difficult. And a foul there called against Baldovi, his second in a couple of moments.
So Lane United need to reassemble here and be smart on this set piece. It's a little bit of a distant, we'll go back with it, that's what I thought. So I was going to say that, you know, a key moment to these games could be set pieces. We know in the past Lane United has given up some opportunities on set pieces, and just being smart of where you're going to foul if you're going to foul, and not giving up anything too close to your box. That is a focus of theirs, I believe, today.
And one of those set-piece goals did come against this Portland Timbers squad earlier this season at Providence Park. Wasn't directly on the set-piece, but immediately after it certainly created. And dangerous movement for the Timbers. They've got the ball in the box. The shot got by Bersano, but it also got by the goal line and will eventually be harmless and eventually a goal kick. Thoughts through the first 10 minutes?
You know, better possession by Lane in the attacking in the middle third, I should say. We haven't really seen get into the attacking third too much till now. But it's a little bit better possession, more composure in the middle. That might be due to the bodies they have in there right now, but they have advanced the ball a little more consistent than they have in the past and have got it to the middle third here. Now the next piece is this. What you see now is in the attacking third.
And Pantoa was whirling out of play there, tried to play the back heel. Couldn't quite make it work. And Lane United have to go back into their own half, but they do keep possession, which is the important part. And get to try and build up again out of play, throw in Portland. Timbers toward the middle of the park. Still trying to get it through to their own number 10.
Well, it's on Baldo's feet. If we can get it down, it's a good thing.
And here's Pantoa. Pantoa plays it forward and no one there for it.
So already we've seen Lane try to establish the over-the-top ball, and that's when it's that much space, it's not going to work. So the key to breaking that is getting a forward or a higher player to come back to the ball and either receive or create space behind him where a through ball could be harmful to Portland. But if players are running away in one long line of attacking players, then it's just going to be too predictable and too easy to defend, and they will run out of space every single time. So having one player come back could really change things in that with that final piece, which we've seen them try to work on the last three attacks.
Timbers again making some dangerous passes put together, and it's going to eventually lead to a corner kick for the side in red and black. Red, by the way, is normally what Lane United wear at home. If you've been following us along this season, you might be a little confused visually, but the Reds in white tonight and the Timbers in their red jerseys. That's something Lane United made aware of and can be the home team's job in the PDL to cope when the visiting team only has one type of jersey.
Yep.
Or so is our going theory. We're not really entirely sure on that one, but as it is, Portland in red, Lane United in white. Throw-in gets right into the box and knocked halfway out, but Portland gets possession again. Try to get the clearance in. Good header there. And back for Wharton. And cleared the long way by Lane United. Go all the way back to Eric Dick, the goalkeeper today for the Portland Timber U-23 squad. Another throw-in for Portland. Wouldn't care to venture the possession numbers particularly equal right now.
Yeah, it's kind of wide open right now. Whoever wants to be the aggressor, just make some better decisions in the middle third, and you'll see yourself possessing a little longer in the spot you want to be, higher up the field.
They tried to play that to Mueller, went over his head, but played it with the side of his foot. That's up into the crowd, and going to be a free kick. And United will take the free kick here. Probably just play short. They do. To Anderson. And now back to De Luis. And all the way back towards Stadler. Stadler tries to play direct to Mueller. He knocked it back to Vanderveld. Lane not as of yet unable to fully unlock that Portland Timbers defense, just trying to kind of pick at it. until they find the right ball. Anderson keeps that in. And now gains himself some space. And more space and more throw-ins for the Timbers.
Well, already more touches by Lane United's midfield, which is a great thing. Now it's important that Mueller and Jones don't turn into the same player. By that I mean just relying on pure strength and physicality. But maybe one of them do that and the other one introduce a more tactical role, which is opening up space for the other and vice versa. One maybe closer to the ball and the other one higher up. But becoming the same player in the same and using the exact same runs in the same space typically won't get you many goals. So, they have plenty of time to fix that. But and I just saw a check by Jones to set that last piece up. So hopefully that stays consistent. But staying as a duo that does the exact same thing and relies on the same tools can make it too predictable sometimes. And at this level, you need to have some variety.
Well, and it would be particularly nice for Lane United to get that variety up top after we've seen it all year. It's really been Mueller and only Mueller up there. But now the play for Jordan Jones and has to be slid out of play by the Timbers. So
better movement, though, by Mueller. He checked to that ball. He created that space. So that's exactly what I was talking about. So there's a visual at home.
Fans, remember to stay up to date with what is happening throughout the league at uslpdl.com.
And it's
a
chance for Mueller to sort of show his versatility a little bit with another forward up there.
Yeah.
It's not to say he's really left us wanting anything at all this season, but it's really been, those seven league goals he had have been really about one different goal scored seven times.
Yes.
So,
yeah.
That's certainly good, but if he has a chance to show us something even more than that, that would be even better.
Absolutely.
Sasavarovic wearing the unfamiliar number 29 today. He's got a different jersey in white than he does in red. Not entirely uncommon at this level. Throw in coming up for the Timbers here. And you can stay up to date with what's happening throughout the league at uslpdl.com. You can also become a fan of the PDL on Facebook. Visit facebook.com/uslpdl for exclusive league news and interactive content. Also follow at uslpdl on Twitter to become a PDL league insider. Join club conversations and track notable alumni throughout their pro careers. One of those pro careers will be getting started soon. Lane United, we can now call him Lane United alum, Will Seymour, will be part of the Vancouver Whitecaps organization. The FC Dallas draft pick will go north of the border. Baldovi tries to chase that down. Good job to keep it in. Here's Anderson on the wing. Anderson will earn a corner for Lane United. And here's the Reds' best chance so far.
Yeah, it was a good run up the line there, and then Baldo keeping that ball in. And earning a corner kick is great effort, and that's good to see. This time of year, results aren't going your way, but you still have players putting it out there like that. That's good to see.
And it will be Baldo to take the corner kick. Baldo Bears, the fans like to call him. Knocked in, it's dangerous, but headed away. We'll come back out for Vanderveld. He goes back to Sasavarovic, who picks himself up after nearly slipping. Tries to get it right into the box, and it's still laying around in the box. Daly Stevens keeps it alive, but it's cleared only briefly. Back for Anderson as Lane United will try to start up once more.
So the composure you're seeing from Lane United being able to play around the back, that shouldn't change going through the midfield. Having that confidence and that discipline in your spacing, and you can still see that type of ball circulation in the middle of the field, and something the players need to understand that even though you've geographically put the ball in a different spot, the composure does not have to change. Yes, you'll experience a little more pressure, but there's still ways to break it, and now you're starting to see a little bit more composure, a little bit more possession, a little bit more opportunities, and obviously player confidence is now a little higher now for most of the Lane United team. So It's early on. That's a great sign going into the rest of this half. Now, the important piece is putting one in the back of the net and really putting yourself in a great spot. But I just see a difference in attitude so far, in body language even, by these lane guys, as opposed to, or comparing them to previous matches. So, thumbs up.
Portland United, important too, you would think, to get that first goal. This is a game that I think, realistically, looking at where the two teams are in the standings, if you can come away with a point, if you're Lane United, you're going to be maybe not ecstatic, but satisfied with that. But if you score first, and all of a sudden you're playing for 3 points and not one, that just changes you mentally through for the rest of the game.
Sure. And you're at home, and you have a good crowd tonight, and you want to get, you know, those 3 points against a respectable opponent. Yeah, it would be great to get that first goal.
And Mueller earning every bit of that foul there, running right through his man. But this is the PDL, and that's how we do it in the PDL.
And if you're Lane, you should be excited that Pantoja hasn't really found the game yet. It's been a little frantic. The service he's been getting from other players is, you know, a bouncy ball, a ball that's not played to his feet. And so Baldo has had some of those opportunities. Now, if you can get both of them with the ball on their feet, you know, that adds another part of your attack, another piece of your attack that, as we all know, can be lethal if they're feeling it. Ooh, careful here.
It was a long clearance from Lane United that Timothy Mueller thought about trying to poach out of the air there. Vanderbilt rather gets in the way of that. Headed Stadler. Sky high, and it will be knocked down by the Timbers, but back towards Lane United, and De Luis plays it up the field. Headed away by Portland and now back by Lane United. Jordan Jones chasing down his man, and will be a throw-in for the Timbers. Good job by Jones pressuring there. The referees will insist the throw-in be taken from the correct spot on the pitch. It is so done, and it is so turned over.
Good by De Luis.
Good job by De Luis. It's going to be a throw-in for Portland, but preventing the build-up play. Paulo V, good job on defense, and that's going to be Lane United's ball, despite the best efforts of the Portland Timbers. Brendan Anderson will throw in. And he goes back for Stadler in a lot of space. Time to think about it. Gets it to Daly Stevens, who's knocked down. Stevens, not one of the larger players on the field. And Mueller just pressuring the back line as the Timbers build out.
Timbers running four up top, a lot of pressure up top if they can get it to that higher line. Careful here.
Dangerous for the Timbers if they choose to use that wing that's opening up, and they do, but then back to the middle for Wharton. Jeffrey D chips it in on the cross, and he had a man to aim for there, but couldn't get it connected in the throw-in for the hosts.
So Portland kind of looking a little unconnected, not really playing with much tempo. But, you know, we saw a similar start to them last time we played, they played against Lane United, and then all it took was one set piece and things kind of broke open after that with as far as tempo went. So maybe they just casually get themselves into games. We'll see.
Sasavarovic restarts slowly back to Stadler. Stadler plays catch with Bersano. Knocks it forward towards Mueller. Was headed, though, by a Portland Timber head, so a throw-in again in a fairly advanced position for Lane United. 25th minute, still scoreless at the Willamalane Center in beautiful Springfield, Oregon, on a very warm day. A And United still trying to get that first real quality shot on target. And it could be created here. Counterattack possibilities started by Stadler. No one there for it. Breaking out on the counter are the Timbers, and down goes a Timber. Nike is a proud sponsor of the PDL. Follow at Nike Soccer on Twitter for all the latest Nike Soccer information. You can also watch much PDL content on YouTube, including the game you're watching now. YouTube is the league's official online video home, offering live games and feature content. Subscribe for free to the PDL YouTube channel today. And of course, Lane United would like to thank its official jersey, beer, and broadcast sponsor, Oakshire Brewing of Eugene. And we'd also like to take this moment to remind you that today's broadcast is brought to you in part by KMTR News Source 16 in Eugene. KMTR is Lane United FC's official media partner. Reds get the throw in here.
Fans, you can sign up for the special halftime event.
And another Lane United throw
in. If you have a child between the ages of 9 to 13, they can sign up for the BIRD program, and the first 6 to sign up will be able to participate in the halftime event where they can win a special prize. BIRD means to be active, and you can sign up for the BIRD program and get your child involved with physical activity in the community.
Another lane throw-in coming up here.
At the Center over next to the ticket booth, at the Springfield Library, or at the Willamalane Center
and
programs. You can find
again,
out
they just sort of are struggling to get much of a sustained attack here. Anything that you think they need to look to be changing?
Well, that last sequence, the ball was on the opposite side of the field, and it changed possession a few times, but neither team transitioned and wanted to take the space that is, you know, really all over the field in the opposite side. So, you know, it could be the heat is affecting their decision making. Could be that physically they're a little tired, but there is a lot of space when after a transition, and because defending team's going to stay compact, but the attacking team seems to also want to stay compact, which is sort of the opposite of what you want from as a coach. You want to really exploit that open space normally on the weak side of the field, on the opposite side of the field. So just pay attention to the transition piece. Do the teams immediately spread out and take space when their teammate's not under immediate support? Or are they just hanging out in the same space that they started off on, which obviously means a lot more compact play and more turnovers? So getting the transition to be faster and really start exploiting the space, which is really everywhere.
Well, everybody's been repaired, so the free kick to restart the game coming up from Lane United, and they play back slowly once again to Stadler, to Sasovarovic. Now he'll try to size up a man and move forward, instead loses the ball. But it slides back to Stadler, and he knocks it back to his goalkeeper.
Also important that the players from Lane United recognize matchups. I mean, I see Baldo here in a 1v1 against the outside back for Portland, and Baldo has already showed himself as a player that will probably win that battle and take advantage of that 1v1 situation. So recognizing that situation and getting your good matchups the ball.
Well, here is Sasovarovic playing it in and may have been trying to connect with Jordan Jones, who was trying to make a run on that whole play. Now back for Baldo V towards Mueller again. He could get it first time, and shot was blocked. You could kind of see that one coming and building.
And Baldo right now is just recognizing tendencies. He knows that the middle of the field is a little too congested for him, so he's finding some space that normally, unless he's moved up as a right winger, but normally center mids don't find themselves there. But he's just reading the game. He's reading the pressure and doing what the game is asking him to do. And I tell you, if he gets the ball, good things will happen.
Can be one of the hardest things to do in any sport is just sort of deviate a little bit from your norm and take what the game gives you, but Baldo's certainly adept at doing that, and the more he can do it tonight, the better it's going to look for Lane United. Counter-attacking chance for the Timbers. They get into the box here, but good defense is played. Now back to the top of the box again for the Timbers.
There you go.
Good touch there. Chance for Lane United now on a counter. Played for Baldovi, and Mueller's going to run back to the middle. They'll get it to him. Mueller takes the shot, and it's saved. Best look of the game for Lane United.
Yeah, indeed.
Hindsight sees 20-20. Maybe you'd like Mueller to have played a pass there, but at speed, hard to see and hard to do, and to get that shot on target, still very nice.
Yes.
But here's danger, and dodging the bullet is Matthew Bersano in Lane United.
Yeah, Lane caught there in a slow transition and allowed a player to get in between the seams, and that through ball was perfectly weighted, but the finish, not so much.
Anderson again towards Baldovi. Baldovi trying to do it all himself and does get the ball back. Man United again with a chance. They get it for Jones, who's just onside. Jones takes the shot himself, high near post, and couldn't get it to come down.
It's a tough angle. I mean, he had the right idea going high, but also he did have runners in the box. So from a coaching standpoint, I would love to see him take that ball a little bit deeper into the box and pick up his head and try to slot it across to the far post.
Just
but
a reminder, fans,
he might have seen something different. He might have seen an open near post. But all in all, that angle is tough as a striker to finish from there.
Would have been maybe a goal of the month nominee if he'd scored that. And shameless plug, speaking of the PDL goal of the month, if you check out the USL PDL website, you can see Timothy Mueller's headed strike against the Seattle Sounders U-23, nominated for June Goal of the Month.
Excellent.
So certainly if you're online right now, which you would be if you're listening to this, check that out and give Timmy a vote for his birthday.
So again, I'm going to pick on Pantoja. He's not getting himself into this game. He's doing a lot of chasing. A lot of the defensive work is, I mean, he's pressuring well, but just not as effective as he's been. He is, to you know, in my eyes, has been sort of a staple in the attack for Lane. And you know, he's not finding his touch. He's complicating himself by, you know, getting the spaces that aren't a little too tight. So if he can find some more space and find the ball, it would help tremendously in this attack.
Yellow card goes to Brendan Anderson there. Slow to get up on the play, but eventually peeling himself off the turf is a Portland Timber. We've got our first train visit of the game. Something for everyone at the Willamalane Center.
So touch tight here, recognizing any unmarked players from Portland and getting this ball out.
And again, the Timbers do have a track record this year of using set pieces to score against Lane United. And it was a corner kick, in fact, in the first half of that Providence Park matchup. Was it the first play, but immediately after where they scored. So kind of about the same time in the match that goal happened. And a corner coming here for the Timbers. So dangerous seconds for Lane United. The corner is played in. And it is headed away by De Luis with the partial clear. Timbers have to go all the way back a step or two into their own half to restart. And they'll play for the far side wing again and throw in coming for it. 34th minute, still no score. Timothy Mueller and Jordan Jones have each had a pretty quality chance for Lane United. Some quality chances as well for the Portland Timber U-23 squad, but no goals for either team so far. Again, this is a Timbers team that recently drew 1-1 against the bottom feeders of this Northwest Division. But they themselves are right up on near the top, definitely in playoff position. So Lane United doing a good job of playing with them, and
careful
in fact,
there. Jeez, that was a rehearsed short corner by the Portland Timbers. It was excellent. It was a player faking like he's going to turn and catch you off guard in a 1v1 and get himself turned into the box. That's just creative thinking.
And short corners can be so tough to pull off, but when you do, they can be quite effective. Timbers now trying to make the right play happen. They go to the near side wing now. Cross played in Anderson there. And Anderson, in fact, will gain some semblance of possession here. Knocks it forward from Mueller, who's all the way into the defensive third, drawing a foul. All over the pitch for number 14. Last 10 minutes of this first half here. So complete this sentence for me, Gabriel. And United score if?
If they have a great mentality going into the next 10 minutes here. This is a part of the game where I think mental fatigue can come into the picture, and keeping the urgency and keeping Baldo on the ball.
The good news for the players is the field is now almost entirely in shade, and that will do something about the mid-90s heat that we had at the beginning. That's crossed in for Mueller. It's dangerous. Punched away in. Mueller and a Portland Timbers player are a little shaken up. In fact, the worst for wear on the play is the Portland Timbers number 70 there. I don't have that name on their roster. And Trainer coming out to help. Also have Amer Sasavarovic lying down in front of Cesar Ocampo, maybe just getting a bit of stretching done here.
Good time for a water break, reassemble, and think about the next few minutes here.
Hydration always important. I may have to find myself a bottle of water at the half.
Absolutely. Or something else.
Many things. In fact, have I mentioned Lane United FC would like to thank Oakshire Brewing, the official Jersey beer and broadcast sponsor for Lane United FC, and quite a good reason to come out and see the boys live. Beer poured until the 75th minute. So overall, we've talked about what Lane could do better to score at the end of this half, but general kind of thoughts, how have we done in the first 37 minutes here?
It's much better. It's a lot more composed and sort of more dimension of attack, I think, has been put on display today. It hasn't just been over the top to Mueller. And that could be because the addition of Jones, some of the backs from the team have something to worry about other than Mueller. But I'm a big fan of what I've seen from Baldo when he has the ball. A very crafty player, loves to go forward and really try to create. But that can't stop. It's good to find a sharpened tool and continue to use it. And finding Baldo's feet a little bit more because he's definitely finding the right space to be in. But also keeping your strikers, the direct line to your strikers, as an option too. And you saw Jones start dropping into the seam, coming back to the ball, opening up space behind Mueller, and vice versa. So already I'm pleased with the attacking ideas. Now the next key is getting everyone involved in the attack, and once again Vanderbilt and Pantoja are outstanding candidates to help your team progress into the back of the net and have yet to really find the game. So it's good news because that can be fixed, but you want to see that happen sooner than later.
Getting toward the 39th minute of play here, so certainly some stoppage time will be following before the game starts. The drop ball restart there, and the sporting thing done is Lane United play it back to the Timbers keeper. Timbers with a chance to make something happen in the final 5 minutes of the half. Or 7 minutes even. Good job there to get in front of that one, and Jones plays that one and has to go back towards Anderson and now back to De Luis and all the way back to Matthew Bersano.
So Lane United have to keep in mind, we've got to be very sharp in the back and not give up one of those goals where it's just a lack of communication or a mental breakdown because so far they've been the aggressor in the game. They've been able to create some pretty good opportunities. But all in all, mentally, just keeping it sharp back there, making sure all lines of communication are open and there's no second-guessing anyone. So the flow of the game gets out of the back the defensive zone fast and not hang, let the ball hang around too much in that third.
We have, unfortunately, seen for Lane United this year more goals than we'd like to see scored against them that were just total communication breakdowns in defense, and not to say, you know, that they've given up every goal that's been scored against them. There have been some nice ones as well, but a couple of big goals that were just misplays and back passes. And Brendan Anderson went down there a little bit behind the play. The fans in front of us not thrilled.
Maybe an ankle or a knee. He got clipped.
We'll see. The referee comes over to take a look. Tonight's center referee is Andrew Brooks, and also an Andrew, one of the assistant referees, Andrew Duker and Ian Miller, the two ARs, and Bennett Savage, the fourth official. Fourth official, I continue to contest, probably the best job in sports. Take a lot of abuse from the coaches, but you get a great spot to watch the game.
You do. Can be solved with earplugs.
Not that any fourth official would ever think of doing such a thing.
No, never.
Anderson's going to be accompanied off the field here. We'll see if he's replaced or if it just takes a couple of moments for him to find his footing again. And restarting again. In the box, have it do the Timbers. They'll get it to the wing, and they try to play the low cross there. Deflected out of play, corner coming up. 42nd minute. Lane United have been good weathering the storm on set pieces so far, but any additional set piece could be the straw that broke the camel's back.
Yeah, and Lane committing all players back to make sure to ensure that this stays out of the goal and they get out in a transition forward.
So they do play it for the heads. It is headed, but not on goal, and Jordan Jones eventually gets to it. And he's got no choice, though, to just clear it out. Another throw-in coming for the visitors.
Fans, remember to sign up for Lane United FC summer camps online. Lane United FC will host soccer camps.
Anderson waved back on, and that's good to see.
July and August. Go to laneunitedfc.com/camps to learn more.
Don't need to take any kind of an injury. And as soon as we're ready for play, there's the whistle, there's the throw-in, and there's the turnover. But not quite able to go the whole way with it. Were the Reds there?
We had Lane United FC coming in for number 13, Brendan Anderson.
So it is a substitution for Lane United, and it is Richie Hurtado onto the pitch.
This is I'm actually really interested to see this. Hurtado, he brings a lot of energy. You can see that he's going to run down every ball. But he might create enough smoke to where Pantoja finds himself a little bit more time and space, which I know Mueller and Jones would love to have happen. I know Baldo would love to see that, so they have one more piece of the puzzle in the attack.
Derek Vanderveld runs that one down. Gets it to Baldo V. Baldo for Richie. Good quality touch there. For Pantoja. And now to Daly Stevens. Sastavarovic running onto it. And Pantoja back to Hurtado. Back for Stevens toward Jones. And not out of the woods yet. Still not out. And that one took a strange bounce and nearly happened very slowly for Eric Dick.
Yeah, that was close.
Good job by Jones there of following the ball and making that a hassle. Seconds left in regular first half time, and then certainly at least a minute or so of stoppage time. Maybe be looking more like two or three. Headed by Portland and saved by Bersano. That was Jeffrey D getting his head on that one. Mueller trying to chase that down. Portland playing it in their defense, but pressure on that back line by Lane United, and the hope being that at some point that can lead to a mistake and lead to a Lane United goal. Meanwhile, though, it's the Timbers threatening now. Timbers looking quite threatening in the dying moments of the first half. Knocked into the middle, and now Pantoa takes it. And Pantoa will probably take his time and allow his teammates to get up on the ball here. Jones runs down to that one. Plays it back for Vanderveld.
Timbers have really changed their attack. They've really gone only to the outsides today. And in the previous match, we're only down the middle. So we'll see if they can balance it out and attack down the middle and the outside. So far, they've only done outside back services, which has become predictable to Lane, so it's easier to defend. But there is some space there for them if they were to balance their attack a little more and try to play down the middle too.
Baldavi gets bowled through, so free kick coming, dying moments of the first half for Lane United. Baldavi taking a bit of a beating already, but
great ball by Pantoa.
Good ball played and not quite enough. Throw in for the visiting Portland Timbers. And too far up the pitch, move on back. It's funny, certain things that don't need to be officiated at certain levels seem to be whistled a lot more at this one. Goal kick coming up for the Timbers. Great crowd on hand tonight. Venture to say is probably our best of the year, but we'll wait on the official number on that one. Baldovi wins possession. Played for Pantoa. Mueller trying to get to it. He just does keep it alive, does Timothy Mueller, and gets it back for himself. Olé, Timmy. And cleared out for a corner kick. Or knocked that off a Lane United body, excuse me. But great job there by Timmy Mueller. Anybody's guess how many moments of stoppage time we have left, so we'll enjoy the ones we've got in the first half. Well into stoppage time here. No score between the U-23s of the Timbers and Lane United Football Club. Played forward by Portland. And misplay there, does just stay in play and has to be cleared out for another Portland throw. They may go long into the box here. Bersano will run on to that one, and that's gonna do it for the first half of play. I think a very satisfying first half for Lane United. No goals, but against the team like the Portland Timbers, going into halftime, keeping them scoreless, that's a very positive thing.
It is. And, you know, really, so far, not much of a threat. Portland Timbers haven't had much of a threat going forward. Lane United definitely opening up the game more, staying a little more disciplined in their spacing, creating some more opportunities up top. But I think for Lane to go into the halftime and come back out, they need to have the idea of, all right, are we satisfied with just getting into the middle third, or are we looking to get into the attacking third and possess? And that definitely should be a goal of theirs with more play through Baldo, Pantoa, you saw at the end there, and really having the urgency to put this team away.
Well, we are going to take a quick break for the rest of halftime here, but we'll be right back with you for the second half. So don't go anywhere. After 45 minutes, Lane United 0, Portland Timbers U-23s 0. And we are back for the second half, and beautiful sky right now. We don't really usually quite get this hour here, the 1 hour later start to our game than we normally had, making things nice summer sunset-y sky, beginning to cool down a little bit. Although I do feel for the Dairy Mart cow mascot who's wearing the full mascot suit in 90-degree weather. I think it probably weighs about twice as much from all the sweat by this point. But the athletes you've come to watch are back out on the field. It's scoreless as we're set to start the second half. Any predictions or anything you notice right away different?
I see a few new faces in there for Lane United, and I'm sure it's just to promote some more attacking ideas. I liked how Lane United ended that first half with Richie in there as a sort of a creator for Baldo, as a creator of Pantoja, and so already you're starting to see that they're trying to attract attention with their holding mid, and then open up the two other attacking mids, which you see Pantoja and. And who's in now?
And Stadler, one of the new Binder, faces, yeah. Binder.
Binder, yeah.
Out there. Number 12. There's Pantoja. Pantoja trying to get to the box and now trying to keep it back for Binder. To Hurtado. And Baldo going to chase that down. Back around the circuit, Golan United. Hurtado. Baldo, but no one there. Or two Baldo, rather, but he couldn't catch up with it. We saw the Red Aces unveil a banner in support of Civic Stadium, the great old ballpark in Eugene, built in 1938 as part of the Works Progress Administration. And has a big piece, not just in Eugene history and Oregon history, bigger. Arguably in American history as well.
And number 27, and,
I'm sure if you are in Eugene, you've heard or seen by now what happened earlier this week. And very tragic as the Eugene Civic Alliance finally able to come together and get the rights to the area and great and ambitious plans for the future of that site. And going to look very different, although it's not going away forever. It's going to be rebuilt in some way, shape, or form, and we can't wait to see what Civic Stadium becomes.
Yeah, definitely a special place. I grew up going to baseball games there, and the feeling of being in an older stadium with the old wood and some pretty good places to view a game. It just created a great environment and atmosphere. So. It definitely will be missed, but I'm sure that the Alliance will sort of reassemble and do what they have to do to reestablish a sports facility there. But it's gonna be tough to fill that void now.
Yeah, one of only 12 all wooden ballparks like that left in the country. Yeah. And unfortunately, you get a small fire going on an old wooden structure, and it's going to be all gone in about an hour and a half is really all it took.
Yeah, and it's unfortunate because that wooden structure sort of had a feel of an older European, lower division soccer club that.
Oh, it could have translated very nicely.
Yes, it would have sort of, I think, could have provided a similar feel visually.
And Lane United play it all the way back to Bersano, who plays it with his feet here to De Luis in the 49th minute. So I believe Binder, the only new face out there for Lane United.
And Furtal here, Casey Chubb-Furtal on the left back. Keep an eye on his attacking ability. He likes to get forward. The first time they played it, Lane played Portland Timbers. He had a great opportunity on goal with a diving header. He likes to push forward. He has great service on his left side. Hence, that's why they have him on the left side. But a couple pieces in there to push forward a little bit more and get that opportunity, that one opportunity that's needed, and then hopefully that one goal.
And
I do see, the first team that scores might end up taking this thing.
Crowd slid toward the edge of their collective seat there, and nothing doing at the end of it. Back to the midfield for Lane United. Tap forward, and now dangerous again. They go to the wing. Bodies in the middle. They get it through, but picked off the bounce by Eric Dick. And a giveaway there from Portland. Matthias Binder with a good move, and didn't have a second one to pair with it, unfortunately, but the first one was pretty nifty. Timbers now cleared away. Back to the Timber back line. And good job there by Stadler moving forward. Got a foot in front of it, and a foul there called against Lane United.
So a similar sequence to a couple in the first half where the ball gets stuck on one side of the field, and then it, the transition's a little slow, but there is space. I saw on that last one here on this near side that had the transition gone across the field, Baldo was in space, you know, a 10 by 10 all by himself with one defender in front of him. So just recognition of having to transition a lot faster and not trying to force it up one side of the field, which would change this game. I think both teams are kind of falling into the trap of trying to make something out of very reduced space and not opening up the field and having the quick thinking to sort out, you know, too much pressure on one side, pop it through the middle, go to the other side.
And Timbers trying to sort of create something there off that throw-in, but it was knocked out of play for a goal kick, and as soon as Matthew Bersano gets a ball, he will take the goal kick. There he is. Now back over to Stadler. Stadler plays it across the back of the pitch, and misplay there. De Luis, I think, maybe didn't quite see it right and had to knock it out of play behind himself.
That was unfortunate because his team had adjusted and anticipated a quick transition forward, and we're all set in place, and then a little technical issue, and the ball goes out of bounds, and the players have to recover into their defensive block. So it's good to see, though, they're starting to align themselves before the ball actually gets there, providing themselves some structure before their attack.
That's good for Mueller. Mueller knocking it down. Mueller takes the shot and up and over, but
so that worked because Mueller was caught in found himself in a one against one, and you know, had some space. The line was a little high, and he's good at exploiting that. He just needs to put it in now. Which, you know, a few more, and I'm sure we will be saying goal instead of shoot. Dang, I wish that didn't go over the net.
At some point, that's the idea. Mueller looking for a birthday present for himself. 20th birthday begins the longest year in any American young man's life. And United still trying to move forward, still trying to combine with Mueller and Jordan Jones, and this could be dangerous if they can get it to the wing to Binder. They do. Binder slows it down, and now towards the middle. Knocked forward. Lane United have broken the deadlock. 1-1. Set up by Binder. Finished by Jones. 1-1. Or 1-0 the score. And a dog pile for Lane United. So there it is. We were talking about it. Red smoke comes from the Red Aces. 1-0 the score in the 54th.
Jones on a great diagonal across the face of the goal. Easy tap in. All you do is make contact and redirect it, and we celebrate.
And that'll make John Gallus feel and look like a genius. His halftime substitution playing a big part in that goal, and Red Ace is not skimping on the smoke tonight.
No.
So very different game all of a sudden as Lane United, who have looked like they've been ready to get that first goal, finally do. And the Timbers an unfamiliar position of playing from behind. They've been one of the most sound defensive teams in the Northwest Division. And any goal against Jim Rylatt's squad is a big goal. Will they respond now? First two or three minutes after scoring or conceding, incredibly important moments. Now Lane United on the counter. Binder again to Pantoa. Pantoa will play another long ball toward Jones, headed but right back towards him and loose in front. And for the second time today, Eric Dick collides with one of his own players. A little quicker to get up though is the Timber this time. Taken away by Binder, who's had a very eventful 10 minutes. Now Richie Hurtado.
It's good ball circulation by Lane United. Now that's switching the point of attack there that I was talking about previously. Ball on one side of the field, but then executing with really high tempo to get that ball out of the space, out of pressure, and finding the opposite side of the field. And that was almost executed perfectly there.
Watch out there in the stands. When cleared away, ended up crossing the line around midfield, so that's where the throw-in will occur from. Playing to the back are the Timbers. The smoke from the Red Aces has dissipated. They'll save more for later. Long ball played by the Timbers and could end up being dangerous. Does end up being dangerous, but knocked out of play for the goal kick. Bersano and a substitution coming for the Timbers.
Timbers might need to make an adjustment in the midfield. That last sequence, the left back has the ball and there's no checking midfielder to come receive. So no support, forcing the ball to be the pass to be a long ball, which Laney Knight will take all day.
And they get it to Binder again. It was off Mueller's head. Now Binder slows it down and plays it back for Chubfertle. Chubfertle again back to Binder. Hurtado there, but Binder plays it for Pantoa on the wing. Pantoa plays it. And all the way to the opposite wing. May not have been the intended receiver, but it will work. They go back and kept in. Dangerous again, headed right to Mueller. He scores! What a volley there! Happy birthday, number 14! You like what you see there?
I did. I like the challenge to build that, to get Mueller in. The challenge to win that 50-50 ball was the play, or the key to that play unfolding and unraveling into a goal. Obviously a great finish, but great work to get the ball to Mueller by sacrificing the body and heading that on.
And that goal may be shaking for some time to come as Mueller really put his foot through that one on the volley and knocked it right in the corner. Absolutely nothing that Eric Dick could do. And all of a sudden, Lane United showing maybe who runs soccer in Oregon. For these 90 minutes at least, as the Red Aces serenading Timmy Mueller with happy birthday. Alex Pantoa on the ball now to Matthias Binder. Out of play, another throw in Lane United, and best 13 minutes of the season for Lane United this second half so far?
Yeah, the urgency is something I haven't seen. This type of tempo is great.
And in a season high for attendance, over 550 people. And I don't think they had to massage those numbers too much this time.
No.
We've got a pretty full crowd here. Lane United not ready to lie down yet.
No, Lane United need to press this so Portland can't find the game again. Just put this thing, put every ball under pressure. Do not back off and fall into a deep defensive block. And just disrupt any type of forward play. And then if you can get your third goal, lights out.
Oh. We talked about the defense this year for the Portland Timbers. Their 1-1 draw at the Puget Sound Gunners broke a streak of 5 consecutive clean sheets by the team. And when they allowed that goal against Puget Sound, it was the first time they'd given one up since June 2nd. And now 2 in the last 15 minutes here. Yellow card coming against Hurtado. And one more time, Lane United FC would like to thank its official jersey, beer, and broadcast sponsor, Oakshire Brewing of Eugene. We'd also like to take this moment to remind you that today's broadcast is brought to you in part by KMTR News Source 16 in Eugene. KMTR is Lane United FC's official media partner. Also, shout-outs all around. Our cameraman tonight is Josh Carter, and filling in at just about everything, including producer today, is Chris Burke. My color commentator, as always, Gabriel Hernandez. Free kick coming for the Timbers, who suddenly trail by a pair just past the hour mark.
Number 38 for Portland Timbers is back door on the second post. Hopefully he stays out.
And dangerous. Hits off a couple heads. Partially cleared. Man United will try and do the rest of the clearing. They do. Jones tried to think about running a long way with it, but
would have been tough.
Would have been quite
he
tough.
He was against three other defenders, so maybe he had a little moment of magic. He could have gone by all three, but that's a tough matchup.
Where's Messi when you need him?
Yeah.
Instead, Lane United will be more than happy to take the throw-in. And we'll see if they can create anything off of that throw. Not as it is now, and in fact, it's the Timbers creating something on the counter. Good job there defensively by De Luis. And a great job there by De Luis, as not only does he clear it out of play, but he's able to get it to deflect off of a red shirt, so it's Lane United ball. A second throw-in coming and a substitution coming for Portland as well. 62nd minute here. Floodlights in full effect as we are getting to be the point where it's officially dark out in the Willamette Valley. Springfield, Oregon, the site today. Right next door to Eugene. 110, 115 or so miles south of where the Portland Timbers call home. Although I suppose the Timbers U-23s call several different venues home. They play every once in a while at Providence Park and then rotate around some other smaller venues and high schools in the Portland area, so not such an easy answer where they call home.
True. That was a tough foul there by De Luis. Again, going back to Lane having to be smart where they're going to commit a foul if they're going to gamble. And in that case, you know, not the most ideal place to give up a set piece.
Substitution for the Portland Timber U-23s coming in for number 73, Foster Langsdorf. Number 4, Anthony Macchione
onto the pitch for Portland. And a very dangerous free kick coming up for them as well.
Jeez. Went for the shot.
Down a Lane United player there, and we're going to have the trainer make his way onto the field to take a look.
Yeah, it looked like a direct shot to the body or to the head. I couldn't tell, but Portland going for a direct shot over the ball, or over the wall, sorry.
Is that that De Luis down there?
Of the PDL. Follow at Nike Soccer on Twitter for all the latest Nike Soccer information. You can also follow at USL PDL on Twitter to become a PDL League insider. Join club conversations and track your alumni to their pro careers.
No, I see Baldo. It's a mystery player.
We'll let you know who it is as soon as we can identify for sure. How about this for a scoreline? Lane United 2, the Portland Timbers 0. And the goal is coming in the span of a couple minutes from Jordan Jones and Timothy Mueller. Both of them gorgeous goals in their own right. And looks like that's
Pantoja
heading for the bench there, and we'll see if we've got a replacement coming on. And once again, the restart. Timbers directly on the ball and directly trying to attack here. Who can blame them? Down 2-0. Still trying to use the wing here. That's really the only way we've seen them attack so far. That's dangerous for Portland. Second shot off the bar. And that one a little bit scary for Lane United. Not much Bersano would have been able to do, but in the end, it rockets off the crossbar and out of play.
Yeah, anytime you get into the box that deep, bad things will happen if you're the team defending. So, fortunate to get out of that with just the ball off the crossbar.
Another foul in the middle of the pitch there. Quick free kick taken by Portland.
Yeah, you see an urgency by Portland. They recognize the score line and want to change that. So they're starting to attack with more numbers, but also some more. The speed of play has gone up quite a bit from how they started the half, actually how they played the game, really.
Yeah, very different look from Portland since they went down by that second goal, but that particular play Lane United will take all day, every day, as the ball sails harmlessly out of play. And Bersano gets set to put his foot through it, 67th minute. Toward the 67th minute now, or toward the end of it. Throw in coming up for Portland. And coming back to it, that's chipped high and over the bar. Another goal kick for Bersano. Timbers continuing to threaten, but not super dangerous. Couple of chances aside. How does this focus for John Gallus and company shift now that you've got this 2-0 lead?
I don't know. I was just looking over their bench. It looks like assistant Connor Capoletti is over there with his leg shaking. I don't know if it's nerves or if it's a habit, but I think they're anxious to get this in the bag and get out of here with a victory. I would continue to preach high pressing, or some pressing when it's appropriate by Lane United, not sit too deep and wait for this and to wait to absorb this pressure that Portland wants to apply, considering the scoreline.
Binder and Hurtado, that's knocked to Mueller and toe tapped out of play. Throw-in coming up in the attacking third for Lane United. Crowd sensed a little bit of something there, and they'll calm down a little bit while the throw-in is taking. Casey Chubfordle will do the throwing, and they may try and get it directly into the box.
Yeah, it's like a long throw, Mueller's head. Or
long throw off Baldo. A bounce for Baldo. And
I like that idea.
Don't see the bounce pass too often in soccer,
smart,
but
very unpredictable, and it was direct. No bounce, I like it.
Particularly off this kind of turf, you really never know what's going to happen.
No kidding.
A Free kick quickly taken. And Mueller tried to take that away. Binder doing a great job. You really have to like the performance that Matthias Binder has put in since coming on at halftime.
Yeah, great on both sides of the ball. Won a lot of balls, pressured the ball well, and then obviously he's supplied some key passes and key moments tonight.
Into the 70th minute here. Going to be a very long 20 minutes. A very long 20 minutes for Lane United, and hopefully a very quick 20 minutes for the Portland Timbers. Clock never seems to move more slowly than it does when you're winning a big game.
An important 10 minutes here. If Lane United can keep the score 2-0, then you put a team into sort of panic mode, more direct play, more numbers forward, so they're putting themselves at risk defensively. So it's either recognizing that and burning them and getting a third goal because of the lack of defending, or pressing the ball a little higher so they can't get into this type of pressure in an attacking third.
Oof. And the referee playing advantage there, and now it'll be a corner taken. Okay. I think the fans initially a little bit worried that was going to be given as a free kick despite the shot being taken.
Right. I think a little deflection by Bersano, but it was minimal.
Corner comes in, headed, and that one more than a little bit dangerous.
Very close. There's the mental part of the game, recognizing every set piece and every sort of time when a dead ball happens to be mentally ready to challenge.
This is where you've got to have that mental maturity that
absolutely
in a league with has an average age of 22, that mental maturity doesn't always come so easily.
No.
Both teams really need to be mature here, because we've seen some fireworks at the end of games, most notably when the Sounders U-23s were in town. Lane United trailed that for most of the second half, 2-0. Then got a goal from Timmy Mueller in stoppage time and nearly got a second goal, although referee felt that they had to enforce the rule that says you're not allowed to run directly through the goalkeeper.
Yes.
Little known rule there.
Yeah.
Long throw in for Portland. A little bit too long, and Stadler chases it down. Bersano collects it, and it's right back to Stadler. Puts the boot through it.
But Lane United look very comfortable with the pressure that Portland's applying. It's not too intense. It's sort of going through the motions. Geographically, they're higher up the field, but I don't know if the effort's quite there from Portland and trying to win the ball back. But Lane United looking very comfortable playing out of the back, dealing with this mediocre pressure and finding their composure and getting this ball forward at ease.
And dancing himself out of his own shoes there was Baldo. That's played forward for Mueller.
But no
Mueller
runners.
Gets to it, but now back to the middle, and now right back to Timmy. Timmy tries to play it in. Back. For Binder, now all the way back to Chubfertle.
Go forward. There you go.
Chubfertle may think about a shot here. He does,
nice.
And I don't think he quite had it on the foot he wanted it there. 74th minute. We'll get that score display updated for you. It is, of course, 2-0. And maybe more coming. We'll get it eventually. One of the 8,346 things that Chris has to do during a game. Not exactly the highest one on the priority list. Whistle goes against Lane United, and 11 white shirts that don't understand it. Not to mention about 500 referees in the stands that would have called it differently.
I think they're all in front of us.
Red Ace is trying to make life a little bit difficult here as Sheldon Sullivan takes the free kick. It's knocked in and...
There's a back post runner, managed to find himself in behind his teammate that was marked and had all the time in the world to sort of align his header there. Luckily, it went wide.
And it did find the head, but rolled harmlessly behind the goal off that deeply rooted tifo.
Bersano can find Binder here on the left. It's a longer ball, but it's plenty of space for Binder to sort of go at Portland and have Chubbs, Casey Chubb-Fertel, follow him, or vice versa.
And there it is, to Chubb-Fertel, to Binder. Binder's been the game changer. He gets it to Mueller. Lost in the middle of the park. Lane United trying desperately to kill off this 2-0 lead, or wouldn't it be great to make it 3? Wow. Timbers trying to just get that first goal and start the comeback train. Foul drawn there by Hurtado. And a yellow card there against Ramilio Hernandez of the Timbers U-23s.
Great last name.
Is that so now?
It is.
Fun name to say, really. Ramilio Hernandez. I like that one. Another train coming by, maybe we'll excite the fans a little bit. Get him going as Bersano gets the restart. Nice play there, and Hurtado's head. Back though, in their own defensive third of the Timbers, trying to move up. Played it there again for Hernandez. Hernandez to the wing for Noah Gaines. Gaines right back to Hernandez to the middle. Halfway cleared and now all the way cleared. De Luis gets to it and steps in front of it, puts his foot through the ball.
So now you may see Lane United fall into the routine of clearing the ball, not taking too much risk. Moving the ball, you know, out of any dangerous zone and letting Portland take command, but sort of reset their defensive block and see out the game this way.
And conversely, this is where you see the desperation mode perhaps start to be entered by the Timbers.
Yes.
And pretty good play there for desperation mode, but not able to quite put all of the touches together.
And keep in mind, during desperation mode, they sacrifice numbers forward, and Mueller is ready for a counterattack here with Jones. Jones particularly,
and
higher up the field.
Jones looked like a sprinter in the starting blocks there, just doing everything he could to stay onside despite his body saying get forward. We've seen that look from Jordan a couple times today, and it's been productive.
Yeah, it's a new look. It gives Mueller a buddy up there that can take some of the attention and let him find some of those spaces. And also, you know, Jones is also a good threat going forward. He does some interesting things in the attack. So maybe John's finding a recipe here for some more success in the end of the season.
And Isma Fernandez onto the pitch.
Isma coming off an injury. Hasn't been around much, but good to see him back and healthy.
Oof. That is less good to see, as he takes a pretty nasty foul there, and it's going to cost the Timbers a yellow card. I think maybe more of a scare than anything else for Isma. always hard to take your first knock after coming on from injury. Lane United restart. And nothing in particular on that one. It goes right back to Eric Dick. Timbers trying to move. Good job by Binder to take it away. Now Hurtado. Hurtado's knocked down, earns the foul. 80th minute. These are the tense ones for both teams. Looking at the coaching staff, I think the Lane United coaching staff might be more nervous though than the Timbers bench. A lot of pacing going on.
I think John is just asking his team to recognize the situation, think about game management here, and not look for the killer ball every time, and you know, look more short combinations, you know, slowing the game down a little bit, and then you know, still building, but not putting a ball into a risky situation where you might give up possession.
Here come Man United. Isma Fernandez in space. Isma takes the shot. It's saved.
Great combination going forward.
Crowd appreciated that one, though. Be careful not to leave yourselves too vulnerable. And right back for Lane United. Right back to Jordan Jones. Isma Fernandez will try to make the run. Jordan Jones tries to keep possession, can't do it. But it's going to be Lane United ball again. And they will slow the pace a little bit here on this throw. Being played back at the defense by Portland. They are running out of moments, are the Timbers. Long diagonal ball. No one in particular, and
that's the ball.
Bersano gets it.
That's the ball you want to create if you're defending, and Lane United will be happy sitting on that all day, and it will likely always end up in the hands of Bersano.
Bersano direct to Mueller. Mueller nearly took a boot in the face there, but it's harmlessly cleared away. That would have been something if Bersano could have gotten himself in the assist column.
Yeah.
Don't remember the last time I saw that. Unless it happened in that Liga Unida game. Seemed to be a lot of balls played direct for Timothy Mueller there.
I might have missed one there. It might have happened.
Very different opponent tonight. And Lane do just keep possession, and well, they'll have to knock it out of play for a throw in. Portland and a substitution coming for Lane United. No hurry.
None at all.
Take your time. Practice the golf swing, make a sandwich, change shoes once or twice, stay hydrated.
Tie your shoes.
And there's the substitution. So now the Timbers really getting into desperate moments for the Timbers boys. Trying to play maybe to the head there, but it's too high and too wide. The Timbers have to go to the opposite wing. 84th minute, that's played into the box. That's dangerous. Shot, save, Bersano! What a save there!
Fantastic job by Bersano. Definitely a momentum maker. Had that gone in, you know, now there's plenty of time for a tying goal. But now, put his team, you know, give his team that much more confidence to see this thing out.
And Bersano had his hand on the ball plenty of times in Portland and really played a great game unfortunately came out on the losing end of it. But tonight, his boys have been able to get him some goal support, and he's been every bit as strong.
Yeah, not much action tonight, which is, you know, the dream, I think, of every keeper.
That's played for. The offside flag does not stay up, as Christian Catalunya was trying to just use his fresh legs to put this game on ice.
It's close.
And here we go again for Lane United, trying to put the finishing touches on this one. Out of play, throw in coming. 85th minute. We said in the opening a tie would have been fine for Lane United. Maybe they heard that and maybe they took exception.
Yeah, they responded. Well, not just effective soccer, but also attractive soccer to watch. You know, everyone's working for one another to create space. People are circulating the ball with pace. Some creative moments and just full-on 1v1 situations. Some creative skills, you know, putting or showcased. So, you know, just a fun way to experience a game and play a game.
And Christians Couto and Catalunya both entering the game. Makes it nice and efficient when they share a first name.
Yeah, C squared.
Chubb Fertile will throw in. Isma Fernandez trying to dance around his man, couldn't do it. But there he is again, number 12, Matthias Binder, got a foot in the way of it, prevented the counterattack. Nearly set up an attack of his own. This is dangerous for the Timbers playing in their own box. Lane United with a lot of pressure on the ball. 87th minute now. And that's Hernandez dancing. Shot blocked before it got through. 87th minute, corner coming. Just about everyone coming up for the Timbers. Even Eric Dix about halfway to midfield.
And everyone on Lane United back to see this, or to get this ball out.
11 Lane United players in the box as they try to clear. That one made Bersano a little nervous, but goes by him. Didn't require a touch.
Nah, Bersano having fun back there. I think he's feeling confidence from that, from his latest save, and you can just tell in his body language that he's enjoying himself, very relaxed, you know. But at the same time, you know, doing his job, he's on his toes, he's anticipating well, and really owning his box.
Got a camera guy, still camera guy, right behind the goal, and hope he got a good shot of that Bersano save, because it was a very attractive one.
Yes.
Tackled by Jordan Jones. Late whistle. And we'll see the medical staff come out to attend to a Portland Timber now. Jordan Jones and his foot involved in the collision. Red Ace is having some fun. When are they not, though?
Win or lose, or tie.
Into the 89th minute now, and however much stoppage time we have, it's going to be too much.
I think John Gallus would agree with you.
Jim Roylott, maybe not so much, but I think John Gallus and I on the same page about stoppage time tonight.
No, beating this type of an opponent, you know, a well-known MLS franchise, you know, sort of the baby brother of them, you know, it does make a difference. And I'm not, it's not disrespecting anyone else in the league, but when you do beat a team that is has a prominent name in the soccer world, you know, it gives confidence to your team. And this is probably an ideal way to start some good momentum going into the, you know, the end of your season. So let's see if this bumps Lane United's confidence up and gets them a few more results in upcoming matches.
Good for name recognition in town, too, to get a big
Absolutely,
win and
sure.
Name recognition in the league. But it is sort of, it's a weird relationship, I think, that Lane United have with the Timbers as an organization. When you go to any other Lane United home game, you see folks rooting for the Reds in Timbers jerseys. Yep. They are, you know, they are not necessarily mutually exclusive fan bases.
No.
But
no.
Big part of what the PDL is about is local support. And you think, you know, the caveat to that might be some of the smaller county teams in England. Mm-hmm. Their fans might still have their Manchester Uniteds, their Arsenals that they root for, but everyone's got a hometown team. Everyone's got a local squad. And
it's easy to be loyal to.
Second biggest city, of course, in Oregon, the Eugene is, and Springfield only makes the metro area bigger. So a lot of support. If the Timbers can do it, there's no reason Lynn United can't do it.
Absolutely.
We are officially into stoppage time. We will have probably at least 2 minutes here, but remains to be seen when that whistle goes. And boy, is this crowd ready to hear it. Cleared away there. Lane United trying to just get any clearance, any possession they can. Binder, it's back to Binder.
Oh, Mueller wide open.
Mueller wide open. They get it towards him. Timothy Mueller knocked down, and the keeper made a save, and the foul goes against Mueller.
It's just, you know, Portland wanting to get numbers forward. Just taking that risk and gambling, considering the time, or, you know, with minutes remaining, and hoping to see if they can get someone. But getting burned there on that counter by Lane.
Nervous moments on both benches for very different reasons. Referee carefully watching play, glancing at his watch. Timbers trying to pick and make something happen here.
Good turn.
They'll go for that wing. They've been trying to play it on the wing all night. Cross comes in, headed away, Lane United, only halfway out. Now again breaking out are Lane United. Another chance to kill the game off here. The job you'd think is done, but anything more would be better. Foul against Portland. Crowd starting slowly to get the point and get to their feet.
So Lane need to be smart and remember that maturity piece of not getting into it with anyone and not putting themselves in risk of any yellow cards or red cards or injuries or suspensions, and just getting out of this happy.
And Red Ace is revisiting a chant that they debuted at Providence Park. If you can hear the audio, we'll let you hear it. If not, we'll let you guess. Not sure it's in the... Something needs to be repeated. Final moments.
Timbers, though, are missing their 4,000 kids that they were at.
It was a bit of a home field advantage. Summer camp day. Day of trying to get school kids and campers a lot of physical activity. And not to be outdone, Verb Oregon with some promotional things at halftime. Bersano kicks through it. Jordan Jones trying to get to the ball. Timbers just, Lane United just hoping, wishing, waiting for that final whistle. It has to come eventually. As we said, though, time moves so slowly in this situation as the home team, the winning team. Lane United have had a couple of half chances to go to 3-0 and put the game officially on ice. Fans getting a little bit restless for that final whistle. Referee has an idea of how much stoppage time is left, and nobody else does. Played through, out into touch again. Towards the middle again for Portland. Lane United gets to it. They clear it. and it goes all the way back now into the Portland Timbers half. All the way back. And blow the whistle is the chant from the Red Aces. And that's one that the rest of the crowd can get behind. Bersano picks that one up. He wants to just boot this one through, have the last kick of the ball. Still not done yet, though.
That's got to be close.
Must be around 4 minutes of stoppage time at this point. Had to just stick a finger in the air and guess.
Or 10 years if you're John Gallus.
At least. His son's about ready to graduate from college at this point. Good shot block there from Stadler. Out of play. There it is, and what a big win for Lane United. It has been an incredibly emotional week for this franchise and everyone involved in it, both with the franchise and outside the franchise, involved with the Eugene Civic Alliance, and to come home temporarily now for the Willamalane Center and put a big 2-0 win on the board over one of the best teams in the league. That is an outstanding result for John Gallus.
Yeah.
Goals come from Jordan Jones and birthday boy Timothy Mueller. That's a great present for him tonight, and that's one of the bigger wins in this club's history.
Yeah, you could tell from the beginning of this game that it was going to be a different result. The ball circulation was better, more composure in the midfield, more possession in the attack. All around, one of the better games by Lane United.
Well, we'll let the cameras keep rolling for a while, but we'll go ahead and take our headsets off. So one more time for Gabriel Hernandez. My name is Isaac Rosenthal. Thank you so much for joining us. And how about that? 3 points for Portland, for Lane United. Almost a force of habit there. 3 points for Lane United, none for Portland. A big 2-0 win, a big emotional victory, and just a great 90 minutes of football for John Gallus. One more time for Gabriel Hernandez. My name is Isaac Rosenthal. Thank you so much for listening, and have a wonderful 4th of July.